So you woke up this morning and you weren't quite a millionaire. We get it. So if you don't have $60 to throw at that newest expensive video game, we're going to show you some fun alternatives that are going to help you be a little more gentle with your piggy bank.
Welcome back to Muscle Play Gaming. In today's episode, we are going to be back in Roblox playing the game Tiny Tanks. The title is pretty self-explanatory. We are now going to be in a tank battle. And yes, the tanks are tiny!
On a side note, we are currently at 850 subscribers. Our 1,000 subscriber giveaway will be happening very soon. Make sure you've subscribed to our channel and have commented on as many videos as you can to be eligible for prizes.
I know what you guys are thinking. Why should I play this game? One thing about it, well, it's free and it's very fun.
So you're going to start out in your own little base here, your spawn point. When you're at your base, you can upgrade stuff. As you can see here, we've already upgraded stuff in the past. Using in-game currency that is free. You can upgrade your tank to shoot faster, move a little better, reload faster, things of that nature. So moving here with the left analog stick on the Xbox One controller. Hey-o, first kill, all right. So the right trigger is what shoots and the right analog stick is what aims. So left stick moves. Right stick aims the turret, right trigger shoots. And you can actually see the other additional controls that you don't use as... Oh, just got my butt blown off. That you don't use as much on the bottom there. It's left bumper, which just switches your ammo types. Left bumper is normal, right bumper is bouncy, which right now we don't have any, but you can buy more. As you can see on the bottom of the screen, it says push Y to buy more. And then left trigger, I can drop a mine down. So this game is not like a team deathmatch. This one, I believe, is called Regicide, which you can see my teammate there, that blue guy. Hey, you got a kill. All right. And a second. Okay, we're on a roll. So basically, I have to protect this king that is right here on my team, the blue king. He's highlighted with a crown, and every basically second, it looks like, that we have this crown, our blue score goes up at the top of the screen, as you can see. So it's very important, and we just took the lead. So the red team is trying very hard to go after him to get that back, because otherwise we're just going to run away with this score. Hey, long distance kill. So I'm going to try to do my best to kind of... Hey! Man, we are killing all sorts of tanks right now. So... You can also see that you can shoot the enemy's ammo, too. Woo! Oh, got me! What was it? Run it to mish. That's the guy that came in. So if you go to see that little wrench and the screwdriver, if you go to that pad, you can upgrade your tank. You can actually buy different tanks, which I have not messed with yet. I'm kind of saving my money for that. So let's see here. Let's protect this guy. So one thing, Muscle Pug was playing the other night, and he only likes to shoot, like, precision shots. He won't shoot unless he thinks he's going to hit him. So my technique, as you can see, is more I'm getting the rounds downrange as much as possible. I'm spraying and praying, because guess what? A lot of times these guys don't pay attention, and they just run right into it. I know it's happened to me personally. It's happened while we've been playing here this last couple minutes. But it's very effective. It can be very difficult to combat, you know, all of these rounds coming at you. So if I have four rounds, I'm shooting them off. All right, our king is tucked away in the corner there. There's only one entrance there on the right side, so I'm just launching rounds at it. Looks like nobody's there. Oh, here they... Nope, never mind. Blue guy. Hey, see? Just launching those rounds. I got that guy. Around the corner. Another one. So we are absolutely crushing the red team right now. I haven't been king at all this game, but I'm pretty sure I had the most kills. I mean, I was up there. Definitely. Oh, yeah. Look at that. 13 kills. More than any other on either side. So, excellent. That was really good. 194-77. So now you can vote at this stage on the score screen for the next map. I voted for Sandcastle, just for a different map. It's also going to be the Regicide mode. It's the same mode we just played, but different map. There's also Team Deathmatch, which the only thing that matters is every time you blow up another tank, your team gets a point. So that's about as basic as it gets. There's also a capture the flag kind of style game. I think it's called Dominance or Domination, where basically there's 3 points, point A, point B, point C, and you have to park your tank on it, and if you sit on it for so long, you will capture it. When you capture it, your team starts gaining points every couple seconds for owning that point. Holy moly, this guy and I are doing a little dance here. I need to let my ammo get up. Phew! Oh boy. Come on. Come on now. Let me get you some. Oh! I don't know how that one didn't hit me. In fact, I think it may have hit me. Got him! Got him! Uh-oh, his buddies aren't happy. Got him! Oh, with the ricochet! So, I mean, you can see. I mean, this is not the most crazy, demanding graphics game of all time. You know, it's simple, and it's basic, and it's fun. I certainly, obviously, can play it. Muscle Plug enjoys playing this as well. It's nothing that's you know, crazy. Anybody can pick up a controller and play this game and truly probably do well because it's so basic. But yet it's so fun. And again, the price tag makes it even more appealing of it being free. So we just started playing this long distance kill. So it, you know, we've only been playing for a little bit. Oh, and another! See? Let's get those rounds out. And, you know, it's just fun. And, oh, to the face. So, you know, you can buy these different kinds of upgrades and things. So you can buy these different types of ammo. There's rocket. It shoots fast, but it won't bounce. Explosive. Looks like it well explodes. So, I need to buy some bouncy ammo and show you guys that. Because it's, I think that's probably one of the most effective ones to use. Especially in these settings like this, where there's a lot of things to bounce it off of, especially with my style of just launching rounds, you know, it can be pretty effective. Got him! Because these normal rounds will just kind of bounce, they bounce, do a one bounce. The bouncy rounds will, I believe, continuously, or at least a lot more than these. So, whew, that was close. I got lucky. Got a round off at the last second. Playing peekaboo. Come on. Come on, little guy. Ow! What the? What was that? I have to watch that one again later. That didn't look like I was hit by anything. Spontaneous combustion. Oh, that little turkey. Gray 22811 was camping our spawn point. I didn't even see him. That jerk. Oh, man. I'm trying to bounce this off the house here and get him. Oh, man. All right, here, incoming. Oh, never mind. Somebody cleaned him up for us. Thank you. So you can see that other teammate behind me, he has kind of a beefier tank. And I think you can just, again, buy different kinds of tank bodies. So you can probably see I am using the bouncy ammunition now. It does bounce a lot more. Just kind of sending it out and letting it... Oh, got one! Oh, there's the king back there. Go get him. Now, I believe if you kill the current king, you are then crowned the king. So... Now in this video, we have yet to be king, but we're busy trying to get kills here and let our other teammates do their thing. Trying to keep the map cleaned up for them. It's been working pretty good so far. We get on these little streaks. What? Do you see that? Guy laid down a thing. Red team wins! Another convincing victory. Another game with the most kills. We're doing all right. So I voted for Sandcastle, which is the current map, but this one is Deathmatch. So it's a. I just wanted to show you guys a different mode, which again, it's instead of the guy running around with a highlighted crown on his head, he's simply just running around as a normal person, part of his team, and kills matter most here. All right, here we go. Bouncy ammo up. Oh. Obviously, our vote did not, the one we voted for did not win. It's not Team Deathmatch. It is Regicide, but it's the snow level, so at least everyone gets to see this different map, at least. So. And we're blown up. So this seems to be a common theme. The blue team or the other team that I'm not on always seems to get it first. And then... And it doesn't look good, but then we get it, and it's like we run away with it. Alright, there's the king right there. Hopefully we can... Oh! Got him with one of those prey and spray shots. See? When in doubt, shoot it out. Alright, so I am now the king, so I'm gonna not do anything too crazy. It's my job to not get killed at this point, so I'm just gonna kind of sit here. You can see my teammate has pushed himself in front of me as kind of a shield. I'm just gonna hang out back here a little bit and launch a couple rounds. Uh-oh, got one coming up the side! Oh, boy! Teammates are on it, though. Shoot, shots going down. There we go. We're doing all right. We're doing all right. All right, they're pushing down. Oh, and we're sandwiched. Crud sticks. That was a good move. Did a little bold flank around the side and got us in the rear. But we have the lead. We just need to get this sucker back quick. Oh, teammate already does. Very nice. Oh, Alex and Ari are the two teammates I'm with here. Ari317. Uh-oh, not in a good spot. Oh, there we go. Oh, to the face. Rocket rounds. Alright, we still have it, and as predicted, our team is running away with it, so doing good. Excuse me, doing well. Get some more kills here. Got 2 minutes. That's another thing too. You're not investing, you know, 15-20 minutes into a single map. If you get stuck with a stinky team, you know, you're not stuck. Oh, as I'm saying stinky team, I get my tank blown up. You know, you have opportunity to get a fresh start pretty quickly. So I went back to that little thing there, the spawn point, and you can see the different types of maps that, or tanks I can actually buy. So So 1,000 for the Ranger, 1,000. Looks like 1,000 for each of them. I have the Cruiser right now. They have different stats. And then it looks like you can get better versions of them for like 5,000 or 7,000 gold. So I'm just going to save our gold here. And then we'll see what we can get with the improved versions that are a little more expensive. So real quick take on this game and Roblox in general. Roblox is a mixed bag. This game itself is a lot of fun. The Bonebreaker game is a lot of fun. There's a soccer game that's on the top favorites list. It's a lot of fun. There are fun, free games on Roblox.
So far, this is one of my favorite games. But this is the second favorite. The first favorite is this pizza place game.
Yeah. Remember what it's called?
Work at a pizza place.
Okay. Got it. On Roblox, right?
Yeah, it's on Roblox.
What do you do on that one?
You basically pick a job, or you can just start at your home. And, yeah, we'll be doing an episode on that next.
And we work as a pizza delivery person?
Yep.
Cool.
Thanks for watching, guys. Like, subscribe, or comment to our channel. Don't forget, take your vitamins, wash your pits, and say your prayers. Bye!